This product is a set. No, it's not a set. This product is a high-end autograph chase. No, it's not that either. It's what is it? It's two sets. It's an autograph chase. It's a free night with a Topps legend. It's well, you know what it is, Rob? It's $27,000.
It's $27,000, which makes it transcendent.
Yes. Topps Transcendent collection, unlike anything we've ever seen, lands Friday the 9th. And first off, just look at the cards. I may have to take back what I said about Dynasty. These may be the ultimate card. I'd have to hold one in hand. I want to hold one in hand.
Those are metal framed. What you're looking at, those are gold metal framed cards you're looking at. Pretty cool.
So, I know, the gut reaction is, $27,000, that's stupid. I know, I'm a collector. I know.
It's a car. It's a down payment on a house.
Well, it's half of, yeah, it's not a down payment. It's half my rent this year. No, I'm just kidding. It's not that crazy. Okay, so there's 65 cases of this, and that's it. Right?
65 briefcases of it.
Yes, yeah. By case, I mean a briefcase, because there's so much in this. I can't call it a box. It's like, for a high end, each box or briefcase has a complete 50-card Transcendent Collection base set featuring a silver frame numbered to 65 and packed within a numbered acrylic box. So I'm going to go out on a limb here and say that the number on the box is going to be the number that's in there. So if you get number 17, you may be some Chris Bryant crazy out there would pay a premium for that. Or if you get number 1 or number 65, because I imagine every single card in that base set is going to be numbered the same. You also get a complete 65-card set of sketch card reproductions. This is in celebration of 65 years of Topps, by the way. I should have started with that. So they've done Mayumi Sato, renowned artist, has done these sketch card reproductions, 65 cards in the set, each one numbered to 65 and packed within a numbered acrylic box as well.
Sick.
So when you open a case of this, these parts and parcels will begin to be divulged out. There's 65 different one-of-one encased autograph cards. I should have waited till the end, because this is really the only reason to buy it, of Major League Baseball superstar Chris Bryant. So every single box is going to have one of Topps' 65 flagship baseball designs.
Every one's a one-of-one.
Yes. They also have, every box will have a one-of-one oversized cut signature box topper. Well, it says in each case, so that's again why I'm getting confused. Are there more than one of these briefcases per case?
No.
Rob?
No.
We need absolute clarification. Okay. Vintage signature from some of the most collectible and diverse stars ever. This is just amazing. Babe Ruth, George Washington, Roy Campanella, President Barack Obama. Should have said President George Washington as well. President Herbert Hoover, President Gerald Ford, would-be President Jerry Garcia, rest in peace.
Unbelievable.
Robin Williams, Jackie Robinson, Richard Nixon, Johnny Cash, Tris Speaker. So they know that sometimes history is more than just monumental. Sometimes it's those ones that are almost impossible to get.
Sometimes it's transcendent.
This is just an absolutely amazing product. Go on GoGTS Live and look at the details, or GoGTS.net. Look at the details on this. Oh, I didn't mention the 49 other autograph cards numbered to 52 or less that are coming in.
Oh, yeah. So let's give it a rundown real quick. You're getting a Chris Bryant 101 autograph. You're getting an additional 101 autograph. You're getting a meticulously honed one-of-one anniversary sketch card.
So there's 65 of those sketch cards in the set that are reproductions that'll be numbered to 65.
But you get one.
You're also getting one of them, one of the original sketches that the reproductions are of.
Yep.
Wow.
The oversized and then to top it all off,
49 additional other autograph cards numbered to 52 or less. Sorry, I skipped the oversized cut as you were saying.
That's right. All right.
The oversized cut that's going to be monumental. They have all 65 of them on the list. Complete 50-card Transcendent Collection base set numbered to 65. Complete 65-card sketch set numbered to 65. And finally, an invitation, Rob,
yes,
to celebrate 65 years of Topps, featuring a very special guest.
Yeah, there's additional information about that on the sell sheet. Not only is there going to be a special guest there, but there's going to be all sorts of prizes and giveaways. That party is going to be off the hook.
Yeah, so that, and that's the other thing. And I know that, yeah, 27,000 is ridiculous.
But it's,
at the same time,
it's an experience. You know?
And there are some people who value the experience very much. There's a lot of people who save up all year to spend a little extra at Christmas and may want to buy into a break of this for a chance at that. You know, and honestly, if you're doing a break and you're breaking it down, like each card, the 50 and the 65 card sets, you could get a lot of people in a break of this for not as crazy as you would think.
I wish I could remember. Someone was running an ad on Facebook for a group break of this, and it was $229 a slot, and everybody got a card, because if you add up the total number of cards, I think it's like 168 or something like that. Yeah,
exactly. That's my point. There's actually a way in this that you can buy into a break for less than some of the flawless and immaculate and dynasty breaks.
Yes, you might walk away with, you know, one of the base cards numbered to 52 or whatever, but when you look at the risk reward on that type of break, it's going to be interesting. I just highly encourage everyone to go at least watch a case of this being broken. Ivan can't commit 100% yet, but he has a chance.
Fingers crossed.
He has a chance to go visit Jaspy's Hobbyland and film a break of this, which would be really cool. So,
yeah, next Friday. So check out Jaspy's on Twitter and make sure that you bookmark their break site so that you can watch the break as well, because...
And if Ivan goes, he'll stream it on Facebook Live for you guys, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, for sure. So anyways, you know, and all that, sorry, I got a little gushy over this. At the end of the day, too, though, it is a collector point to talk about, and I see people talking about it in chat. But consider there is a space in the hobby, I think, for this, especially as the hobby, what we want it to be is art. We want it to be art and collectibles, and this elevates the game into that echelon, potentially. So I think that as long as we take it for what it is and don't assume that it's replacing flagship,
right,
I think there's a strong place in the hobby for a certain number of these.
Let's also remember that it is an anniversary-type product, the 65th anniversary. And I think the biggest part of this, as we talked about, don't forget the experience. That's a VIP experience that some people would spend that kind of money alone for, let alone what you're getting. So I'm not in any way trying to say that, you know, every company needs to make one of these, but I do agree with you. There's a time and place for a product like this, and hey, you know, what better way to try it out, you know, but on your 65th anniversary.